Hi, my name's Jeany Spark. I'm a film and TV actress from London, UK.
Jeany, it's amazing to have you with us tonight. Why is it so special and important to celebrate and support independent storytelling?
It's hugely important because it's kind of independent filmmaking is one of the few ways we have to safeguard the stories which otherwise wouldn't get told, which might not get picked up by broadcasting houses, TV companies, or film companies. I think if we can safeguard places like Raindance Film Festival, where independent filmmakers can tell their stories and get them out to a wider audience, that's absolutely invaluable. Otherwise, you know, we're going to just get a thin band of the same kinds of stories, and that's not what we need.
Collateral has had a phenomenal response. Can you talk a little bit about what it is about Sir David's writing that is so special, so unique as a performer?
He is, I mean, one of the greatest living playwrights that we have in the UK. And what I've always loved about him, from his stage shows as well as from his film work and now his TV work, is he's absolutely fearless. He's absolutely unafraid to take on big institutions like government, like the church, like the military, and ask really difficult questions. I just really admire that.
I think obviously we've seen many different iterations of the spy world and the kind of consequences of that. Can you talk a little bit about what you think Collateral had to say about that was perhaps unique, something new in that field?
I think the link between the world of espionage and MI5 and the spy world with the kind of the ground politics of immigration, particularly in the UK, which is a really hot topic. I felt like it was integrated in a really good way in the Collateral script, in a way that I haven't really seen before. I thought that was fantastic.
So it was a fantastic cast alongside you. Can you talk a little bit about what it was like working with that amazing team, and particularly, I mean, a wonderful performance from Kerry Mulligan?
Yeah, I mean, she's astonishing. She's absolutely amazing. Yes, I was absolutely terrified on day one. I walked into the read-through and sitting around a table with Kerry and Nicola Walker and John Sims and so many other actors who I've grown up admiring, and feeling a little bit like, oh my gosh, I have to really step up my game here. But it was an honour and a delight.
I think obviously there's a huge discussion going on at the moment involving ERA 50-50 and that change. Do you think that it's particularly inspiring to see shows like this, particularly crime dramas and espionage, that are being female-fronted, very much female-led in the narrative?
Yeah, I think it's enormously important. Women make up more than 50% of the population in the UK, and yet when we're represented on screen, we're lucky if it's one in three. Children's television, I think, represents three men for every one woman, which is not a message which is great for the next generation of kids to grow up seeing. So anything which promotes women and their visibility, you can't see what you can't be. So if a woman isn't in a position in a drama playing a doctor or a policeman, then we're always going to say policeman. We're never going to say police person or police woman. So, yeah, it's important.